You are now tuned in to I Am Encouraged Radio. Yes, friends, you are now tuned in. You're locked in to I Am Encouraged Radio, and I am your host, Pastor James. And friends, today's show, we have a very special show for you today. Because this is Valentine's Day weekend, today's show is for the lover in you. And I know that there is a lover in you, whether you're singled or married. There is a lover that exists within you, someone that just wants love, that desires love. And if you're married, then you've got the love of your life. But if you're single, you've got Jesus Christ. And so we're going to do this show for the lover in you. And friends, I'm so excited about it. I've got some Darlene McCoy on deck for today. Forever Jones with a love song to the Father. And we're going to go ahead and get things going just for the lover in you, for all the ladies out there who desire and chase after God. I want to play this song right here. It's by Kenton Jones. It's an old one. It's called Holy Ghost Girl, here on I Am Encouraged Radio and the Accelerated Radio Network.
The prettiest thing I've ever seen was a Holy Ghost girl. And when she hits the scene, don't know what I mean, 'cause she's a Holy Ghost girl. The prettiest thing I've ever seen was a Holy Ghost girl. Smartest, kind-hearted woman in the world is a Holy Ghost girl who's living in her Holy Ghost world, and she shines like a Holy Ghost pearl.
We'll pray for you all day for you
to go to church. You must
go virtuous.
Woman in the world has the Holy Ghost, and this girl loves God the most.
Well, we'll present from coast to coast,
and in the Word of God she'll boast. Says the Lord,
and heavens are just reward.
And I must confess that in all this raunchiness,
that she will stand for righteousness
and will not be a part of me.
The prettiest thing I've ever seen,
pretty girl,
was a Holy Ghost girl. And when she hits the scene, you know what I mean, 'cause she's a Holy Ghost girl.
You're gonna know that she goes a Holy Ghost.
Sanctify,
Holy Ghost, feel,
and
by baptize. Say, for a ride. She's gonna walk in the light. She's gonna win every fight. She saved, cause she had Jesus, my Savior, my healer, my friend, my deliverer, Jesus. The prettiest thing was the Holy Ghost girl, living in her Holy Ghost world, shining like a Holy Ghost pearl.
That was Warren Barfield with Love Is Not a Fight. And that was a shout out to my gorgeous wife, the love of my life, Kristen. You know, that is a song we actually heard him perform live when we went to a Carré Joe concert. He opened up for her. And he shared his testimony, and his testimony as to how he wrote that song, how he came up with that song, is just so powerful. I encourage you to go and check it out on YouTube. You can search Warren Barfield, Love Is Not a Fight, and there are several videos there where he kind of talks about his testimony as to how he came up with that song. And then the song ended up blessing so many people because it went on to be on the movie Fireproof. And friends, that is a blessing when God can take your pain, your tragedy, your situation, and use it to bless the nations. That's why you can't hold back, you can't hold it in. But you've got to just share your testimony, whether it's good or bad. Whenever God delivers you, you've got to share your testimony because it's going to bless somebody. Well, friends, we're going to switch modes a little bit. For the first few songs, we've been talking about, you know, the love between person and person. But, you know, the reason why we're really here is to express our love to God and how the Father loves us. So we're going to keep things rolling with Kim Burrell and Jesus Is a Love Song here on I Am Encouraged Radio. On the Accelerated Radio Network and Spreaker.com.
Your tell you what it is.
It's to me.
What he really means to me. Hey, that's what you mean to me. Love you with an everlasting love. I do. That's why I sing the way I do. Cause you are the song in my soul.
What can these fragile hands
You're so awesome. You're the giver of all hope, love, and peace. Let your love always surround me.
I adore you.
Father, I adore you.
That was Darlene McCoy with I Adore You. And friends, we're going to go ahead and keep the music rolling and keep showing our love to the Father with Forever Jones and Adoration here on I Am Encouraged Radio and the Accelerate Radio Network.
which way to go. I climb down on my knees and I pray for you to help me through the night. I wanted to make it another day to see the morning light.
Every night and every day
you cared for me in a special way.
You are the reason why I'm here today.
I was made to bless your name.
I bless your name. Oh, I bless your name
for everything that you've done for me.
You spoke to me.
You spoke to
you
me.
You spoke a word.
Yes, you did. I heard a word one day.
I heard a word one day. And this is what he had to say.
He told me that.
He told me that
everything,
everything would be alright.
And every battle,
every battle he would fight.
I was gonna make it.
That I would make it through the night.
He spoke the word.
He spoke a word and it changed my life.
I heard the word he spoke to me. And in that one word was everything I would need. He told me that he would be my friend, and on him I could depend. He told me if I ever needed him, all I had to do was call on him. He told me get ready for a new day. My life was gonna change, I would never be the same.
Every night,
oh,
and every day,
you cared for me, Lord, in a special way.
You are the reason why I'm here today.
I was made to only worship you.
I bless your name.
I bless your
I
name.
Bless your name
for everything that you've done for me.
You spoke to me.
You spoke to me.
You spoke a word
and said a word. Oh Lord,
I heard a word one day.
One day when I felt like giving
God
up.
Spoke to me, and this is what he had to say.
He spoke to me.
He
spoke
me that
to me.
Everything would be alright.
Every battle.
Every battle he would
fight. You
can
just hold your peace.
That I would make it.
Yes, friends, God will speak to you. God will give you a word and let you know that everything will be all right. He will let you know when the time is right for love, when God will let you know when it is time for you to step out and do all the things that he desires for you to do as it relates to love. That's what this entire show has been about. That's what we've been talking about throughout this entire show. And so I want to read a special word from the Lord for you today. It comes to us from Songs of Solomon, and we're going to start on chapter 3. When you get to chapter 3, verse 1, you'll find these words. It says, "All night long on my bed I looked for the one my heart loves. I looked for him, but did not find him. I will get up now and go about the city through its streets and squares. I will search for the one my heart loves. So I looked for him, but did not find him. The watchmen found me as they made their rounds in the city. Have you seen the one my heart loves? Scarcely had I passed them when I found the one my heart loves. I held him and would not let him go till I had brought him to my mother's house, to the room of the one who conceived me. Daughters of Jerusalem, I charge you by the gazelles and by the does of the field, do not arouse or awaken love until it so desires." Friends, what I simply want you to know and what I want you to get out of this word today is that God will lead you in the time, and you will know when the time is right for love. Friends, I know that so many of us throughout our lives, we begin to get desperate. We begin to search and to seek and to chase after people, and we want love in our life. And we say, well, I'm this old and I should have gotten it by now. I'm this old and I thought I would be here by now. But friends, what I want you to know and understand is that God knows what time is right. And just as it says in verse 5, it says, "Daughters of Jerusalem, I charge you by the gazelles and by the does of the field, do not arouse or awaken love until it so desires." Friends, I want you to know and I want you to understand that when the time for love comes, love will find you, especially if you're a young woman, if you're a woman of God. You see, within Encouragement Ministries, within the past few weeks, we've been doing the love, marriage, and relationship study, and we've been talking about, we specifically talked to the women and told the women about how to keep themselves and how to listen to the Holy Spirit. And when the time is right, the Holy Spirit will prepare you and put you in the place where you need to be so that your Boaz can find you. And friends, I just want you to know, men of God, I just want you to know that all you have to do is just trust God, is just follow after God, chase after God, and God will bring you to the woman he has for you. And she will be right there, ready, willing, and able to accept the love that you have. Friends, I am so sure of it because this is my very testimony. Friends, you see, I met my wife a couple of years ago when I was out doing the work of the Lord. I had been preaching earlier that morning and I was invited to come and rap at this church that I had never been to, had never heard of. But I went anyway, and I went, and as I went, I remember pulling up into the parking lot, and there across the street was the most gorgeous young woman that I had ever seen. And because she was so fine, I said to myself, this woman has got to be taken. There's no way this woman can be this fine and not be engaged, not be married. So Lord, I want one just like her. Lord, take her, make another one like her, and send her my way. Friends, I want you to know, even though I did not fully listen to the voice of God to see if she was the one, I was too shy to talk to her and to really get know if this was the one for me. Ever since that day, I could never get her out of my mind. And I would just hope that maybe I would see her again, or maybe I would meet her again. And then I saw her. I saw her, and when I saw her, I had to find out who she was. I found out who she was. I found her name, and I was like, wow. And I began to pursue her and chase after her. But it all happened as I was chasing after the Lord. You see, I met her in one church, and then I went to what was my home church at the time. And while I was there, I looked over my shoulder and I saw the most beautiful woman worshiping the Lord. See, friends, that's how God will bring you two together. He may allow you to see her or see him, and you'll think, oh, I would love someone like that. I would love something like that. But you don't think you deserve or you can obtain, you can have that person. But friends, I want you to know that as I waited on the Lord made it possible for things to be set right, for things to be in order. And friends, I don't want you to get in a rush searching for love. I don't want you to be in a rush chasing after love, because you see, from the first time when I saw her, after that, I didn't talk to my wife. I didn't get a chance to see my wife again, you know. And so what ended up happening was I ended up talking to four different women in 1 year before I got to actually talk to and start the relationship with my wife. And I was just going from woman to woman to woman, hoping that I could find something in these women that I could create and make into be what I desired. But friends, I want you to know that when you chase after God, when you seek after God, he will give you the desires of your heart. The Lord knew my desire was for Kristen, and so he brought her to me. He brought me to her, and we both caught each other's eye that first day, and she'll even tell you that she was just praying that maybe one day we would see each other again, that we would connect again. But friends, in God's timing, all things worked out. I remember one time when I saw Kristen at the church that I was at, and she was there worshiping. I went and talked to her after service. I had to know her name, more about her. Actually, I knew her name. I just wanted to know more about her. And as I was talking to her, the young lady who I was talking to at the time, who I was in a relationship with at the time, walked up and she stood beside me, and I froze up and I was like, oh Lord, I'm busted now. But friends, I want you to know that God worked all things out. If you will say that you love God more than anything, if you will chase after God more than anything, he said that he will add all these things unto you. Friends, I want you to know that if you follow after God, chase after God, love will find you. Love will come when the time is right. Friends, we're going to go ahead and get right into this music. And I want to play Lamar Campbell and More Than Anything. Because friends, you've got to love God more than anything. Here on I Am Encouraged Radio and the Accelerated Radio Network.
Oh, can sing to you this song. I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Love me in your arms. You are my shelter from the storm.
out of this text.
Big Al with a song called BFF. And friends, I want you to know that Jesus, God, will be your BFF, and he loves you no matter what anybody else says or does. Well, friends, it has been my pleasure to bring you I Am Encouraged Radio. I pray that this show has been a blessing to you. I pray that you have enjoyed this show here today. And friends, I want to let you know that We are so excited about everything that the Lord is doing. And if you enjoyed this show here today, then we want you to go and check out our Ustream services, our Ustream channel. And there we are talking about love, relationships, and marriage. And we are about 4 weeks in, 3 weeks in. And I am so excited because God is really speaking and moving in that series. And you can find us there at I Am Encouraged TV. Or you could also search Encouragement Ministries. And friends, we also want you to check us out on YouTube at 21 Days of capital ENC. And there you can find all of our series from the 21 Days of Encouragement, ranging from the Labor of Love and all the other series that we've done. Then, friends, I want to encourage you to also go and like us on Facebook. Join us on Instagram, on Twitter. The Facebook page is 21 Days of Encouragement. The Instagram and Twitter is 21 Days of ENC. And friends, if you have any prayer requests, concerns, comments, you can always leave them on the Facebook or email us at 21daysofencouragement@gmail.com. Friends, I want to thank you so much for tuning in. It has been my absolute pleasure and joy to bring you this show today. So we're going to close things out with a good old-fashioned gospel song from the late Bishop Gilbert Earl Patterson with "Look Where the Lord Has Brought Me From." This has been I Am Encouraged Radio here on the Accelerated Radio Network.
Let me go off the sheet for a minute. Look where he brought me from. Oh, look where he brought me from. Shoulder. my God. Why don't you tell him, Lord, I just want to thank you for where you brought me from. Thank you for where you brought me to. And my faith, thank you for where you're leading me.